What's going on, guys? It's me, Xander, back today with another video. And we are back for another episode of Subnautica VR. Now, last time, I did not have my voice because it was 10 at night when I was recording it. But now, here I am. So, I think my goal for this episode is going to be actually doing some progress instead of just dying to ghost leviathans. So, see, I was just kind of boring. Remember, my goal was to go over there, close my eyes so I didn't scream. It's terrifying. It wasn't really that exciting anyway. But then, that when Reaper Leviathan came out of nowhere, sabotage everything. I didn't even know they could go to the surface. Oh, it's a whole crap. I'm about to fall over. What the heck? Well, I mean, can you hear me?
Oxygen.
Ah, dang it. I was like, wait, can I see the Lost River and stuff? I'm sure my. I'm sure if it was rendered far enough. Might be able to do that. For now. I really like a Seaglide, that sounds pretty cool. Copper ore, nice, nice. Titanium.
Life on this planet grows in unusually distinct and diverse ecological biomes. Further study recommended.
Ah, good old further study. Recommended. Also need to connect to my computer to play some Monaco VR. But I have this crap. A really big. Thank you. I got lots of good things today. That is a stalker. Truly entertaining gameplay. I always thought you spawned on the far side of the world, like over there. Did I start playing again? They spawn on like whatever side we're on now. I swore you spawned on the other side. I digress. The sea glider is gonna go much, much better. I thought the PDA said something. still 158 kilometers. I mean, meters, not kilometers. Big 0.1 kilometer away now. Okay. I don't know how well you guys are going to be able to hear me because I'm facing the other direction of my computer, not facing. My look around thing doesn't work. So I just have to run manually. Let's see what we got. Also, that was not the right thing. Thank God I'm old.
Lubricant is essential in construction of vehicles and power plants.
Yay, Seaglide!
The Seaglide will increase your effective exploration range. For your safety, please pack supplies for long journeys and stay within 5 kilometers of the nearest life pod or habitat.
I forgot. I got that. Whatever. I don't really see my food, but I can just barely see it. I think I need to eat something. Let's get one of you. Oh my gosh. Let's just use this. There we go. I'm pressing A. There we go. So actually, I'm also Oh, that is so much faster. Are you seeing this? Also, it takes up a lot more of my... if I look up, it takes up all my... What was that? The Aurora? Might have been. Okay, look for some titanium. It also hurts my neck to just look directly down.
Local scans show a nearby cave entrance, depth 90 meters, leading to an unknown environmental biome.
It probably is, though, I'm gonna be honest. Oh, we're 7 meters down. I would like one silver. What is that? Did you hear that? I mean, I can't see that. It takes up all of my vision. You know, that's gonna have to do something. That's probably got something to do with what I'm hearing. I gotta be honest, I don't like it. It's like over there. Creepy boys. You almost gave me a heart attack. And many nightmares. Except, recently I've been having just Subnautica themed dreams. Excuse me, I can't.
Silver-based wiring kits are an essential component of many habitat modules.
Thank you. Thank you. I got that one silver I wanted. Keep me drowning now. That's not good for my health.
Oxygen.
This thing is low key on me. So look at it. Oh, there's multiple soundtracks in front of me. Just my VR headset. Looks like it also like that knife.
Weapons were removed from standard survival blueprints following the massacre on Braxis Prime. The knife remains the only exception.
Okay, we need table coral samples. Look, I got a knife. Ooh. Okay, here we go. Okay.
New blueprint acquired.
If I, you know, if I could see, would be a bit nice. Oh. That's titanium. All you see is the same thing. You guys? I'm gonna make any of the acid mushrooms, because I'm an idiot. I wonder if you guys have acid mushrooms or battery acid. Oh, I just realized this. Am I stupid? Probably.
The builder, too, is designed to construct habitats capable of withstanding extreme environmental conditions.
Actually, I'm gonna fix you first.
This is an alarm. Distress signal received. Rescue operation ready dispatched to your location 9 hours. Continue to monitor for emergency transmissions from other life pods.
Life pod secondary systems online. Running full environment diagnostic and outputting results to data bank.
Oh, my family's home. That's crazy. Are you serious? Get back here! Oh, there we go. I mean, that works. Let's make one of these. Oh, we got a tube! If I could press the button. If I could press the right button, that actually kind of nice. What about you?
Warning, emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Any copper? No. Any copper? That damn drone? I can barely see it. I can see just enough that I know I'm about to drown. Okay. You know, after I make this, I'm gonna have to call it quits, okay? But, if I can see. Actually, no, I want to be down there, man. Wait. Oh, I'm stupid, there's no sun. Well, I'm gonna call it there, guys. I'm gonna go back in here. I think that's a pretty color, but after this is it.
Land re-recorded. Distress call.
This is Ozzy from the cafeteria. What the hell,
it's
guys?
Ozzy. Come on, man.
They didn't want us. This might happen.
Bro,
our pod was almost crushed by the Seamoth Bay on the way down. Now we're hanging on the edge of a cave system, and this grim-looking snake thing's trying to eat through the hull.
This is tough, man.